Hello everyone, I'm going to start on another project, and this time I'm going to combine resin and alcohol inks again. I want to develop myself a little bit more with this combination, and in this video I show you how I add the first layer of alcohol ink and also the first layer of resin. I'm also testing a pre-gessoed wood panel. And I'm also going to try to make some colorful bubbles again. So for the people that are new to my channel, consider to subscribe, click the bell, because then you don't miss anything, because then you get notified every time I upload a video. So I already started with adding the alcohol ink to my wood panel, and this is a pre-gessoed wood panel, what I already mentioned, and I'm going to see if the wood panel is suited for applying alcohol inks, and I'm also using alcohol 99.9%. And first I'm adding the alcohol to my wood panel, and on top I put some drops of alcohol ink. There you can see it. And I'm also using an airbrush. I bought myself an airbrush to see what the difference is if I use an airbrush or a heat tool. This is the heat tool, embossing tool. And I'm blending all the colors. All the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, because I'm using a lot of colors, but also in the description box below this video with the links to the websites, so if you're curious then you can check out where I buy my materials. So on the bottom part I used a black alcohol ink and a rust alcohol ink. I think that looks nice. And in the middle part I'm using two different shades of green and a yellow. Yeah, what I already mentioned, I want to develop myself a little bit more in using alcohol ink. So you see me try different techniques, and that's the way of me experimenting with different mediums. And I want to make a very colorful painting, that the colors stay vibrant, so not a lot of alcohol mixed with it or a blending solution. I want to have the colors as vibrant as possible. And on top of this, I'm going to add a resin layer. And I'm thinking about adding more than one resin layers, so that I can create that depth. So now I'm working on a top part. I'm using different shades of blue, there you can see it, but also a yellow and a red and a magenta. There I switch to the heat tool to see what the difference is, because with the airbrush you have the cold air, and with the heat tool you have the warm air. So I want to see what difference it is, except for it drying faster with the heat tool. Trying to blend those colors together, and every time I look at the design and how the colors blend together, that they don't get muddy. Now I'm placing some glasses on top of the still wet alcohol ink. I want to see if I can create the nice colorful bubbles again, but they don't have to be perfectly round. I can define them a little bit better if the alcohol is dry. You will also see that in this video with a brush. Adding some alcohol around the glasses using my heat tool again. This video is all about experimenting not only the wood panel, if that works, because that would be great, because then I can buy them also here in Germany. But also experimenting with alcohol inks and resin again. And before I can put resin on top of it, I will spray it with an acrylic spray varnish and then the satin or the matte. You don't want to use the gloss, because that will not react good with the resin. So if you spray it, then you need to have a matte or a satin one with a UV protection in it. And that will prevent that the alcohol ink will bleed in your resin. So several layers on top of your alcohol ink. And then it's protected for the resin. So you can see I use a lot of colors. I like using vibrant colors. And yeah, what I already mentioned, you can find them at the end of the video with the names and the brands, but also in the description box. Taking my glasses off my wood panel, drying the middle part. Yeah, there's not a lot of contrast at the moment. But the great thing about alcohol inks is that you can change it as long as you want. There also not much contrast, so I need to do something about that. So I'm drying it with my embossing tool. Now I'm adding some gold, because I also want to try out the gold and the alcohol. And I let it drip down, because I'm tilting my wooden panel. Because I want some golden lines in it. But yeah, that way I'm also going to lose the bubbles, but I can change that or adjust them. You can see it. The gold dripping down. Again, I'm going to place the glasses on it. What I already mentioned, you can change as often as you want or as long as you want. So I'm adding some alcohol around it, not too much. Using my airbrush to blend the colors. Also blowing the gold against my glass. And now it looks a little bit messy, so I hope I can change it along the way. I also need to get used to my airbrush, because I never used an airbrush before. This is the first time. Adding a little bit of gold against the glass, and then I'm blowing with my airbrush. There you can see it. And what I like about this airbrush is that I can adjust the air that comes out So that's great. So that I don't blow the ink all over the place. Again, some rich gold and a little bit of alcohol. Taking the glasses off, and right after that I'm drying the middle part. They can see it with my heat tool. Still not much contrast. But I will try to change that with some details that I'm going to apply with my brush. There you can see it. I'm using the gold, and I put a few drops of the alcohol ink in my plastic cup, and then I'm adding the gold in the places where I want it. Also the bottom part where I have the darker colors, the black and the rust. And what I also want to mention is that YouTube made some changes, and it's all about the notification bell. If you don't click the notification bell, and then it is possible that you don't see any videos from me anymore, even if you are subscribed to my channel. So please check all your notification bells if you pressed it or not, because then you will see every time I upload a video, and I would appreciate it a lot if you click that bell. Still adding some golden accents. Yeah, you can't see it that well, but at the end of this video I will show you all a close-up, then you see the gold much better. So if you are curious, then you can wait until the end of the video. Yeah, it still looks a little bit messy, but it's colorful, that's for sure. But I hope that when I add my resin layer, that I can adjust that a little bit. Working on my larger bubble. Again, some gold. I can see it. So I'm thinking about making this painting in more layers of resin. I'm not sure yet, but yeah, maybe I can create that way the depth that I want, and also with some the layer you are going to see later in the video is all transparent colors with some sparkle in it, but maybe after that I can add some opaque colors. I don't know yet, but yeah, if you use opaque colors, then you cover up the parts underneath. So I need to think about that, if I want that. So let me know what you think. After seeing this video and how it looks at the end, do you think I need to add another resin layer or and opaque colors, or do you think it's done after this video? Let me know, please, in the description in the comment section. I'm very curious what you all think. Again, some gold in the larger bubble. I can see it. Yeah, and then I'm almost done with the alcohol ink, and I need to let this dry and then give it a varnish so that it's protected for the resin. So it's dry and now I can start with adding resin. I'm using different colors of Bombay ink. The first color is the aqua, and I mix some blinged blue in it so that it gets a sparkle. And I made them very transparent so that you can see the alcohol ink through it. I'm also using the teal Bombay ink, so that I have two different shades of blue. And I'm also using the Signorita Magenta, and I mixed some blinged red in it, the blinged from Color Art, so that will sparkle also a lot. And I'm using the bright red, that's the bright red I'm using at the moment, and also these two colors are very transparent. Some clear next to it. And in the middle of my larger bubble, I'm using the yellow color, the Bombay ink yellow. And next to it, the clear. And then I'm spreading it out. So on top of my alcohol ink, I'm using transparent colors with a lot of sparkle in it. I think that can look great. And the next color I'm using is the Bombay Ink Grass Green. And also in this one I mix some Bling It Green to give that one a sparkle. And again the yellow. So in the middle part I'm using the grass green with some Bling It Green in it and the yellow. And again some clear so that it can flow into the clear. And then I'm spreading it with my stirring stick. And again I'm using the Harion Resin Art Epoxy Cast. And that's the new resin of the Dutch company that I'm testing. And so far the paintings I made with it are great. They have an amazing finish. So they look like glass. And I like that very much. And the working time is also very good. It's at least 1 hour. So that's great. But I want to test the resin a little bit more. And this is a FW ink from Dalarani with some Bling It Gold mixed in it. Also very transparent, because I want to see the alcohol ink through the resin. But so far the resin from that Dutch company works amazing. I like the viscosity of it. It's not too thin, also not too thick, and it holds the effects I'm creating with it. So that's great. But I'm going to test it more. But for the people in Europe, it is available. I will put a link in the description box so then you can check it out. Adding a little bit more of the Signorita Magenta. And already it's looking a little bit softer. So not that messy anymore. And that's because of the Bombay ink colors, the transparent colors. It tones a little bit down the alcohol ink. So that's good. Again, some clear on the bottom part. Adding a little bit more of the FW ink, the black FW ink with the Bling It Gold mixed in it. Spreading it with my stirring stick. More clear next to it so that it can flow into the clear. Yeah, and I think the colors look great together. Very colorful. Very bright. I like that. But I still need to learn a lot because this is only my third painting with alcohol inks. I think the fourth. So there's still a lot to learn. But I like to show you my process of developing myself with alcohol inks. but also the process of making these paintings. And I will put also the links to my other alcohol ink paintings in the description box. And then you can see what I did before this one. The torch for the air bubbles. And I must say, this resin doesn't have much air bubbles in it after mixing, so that's also good. Yeah, I want in that area, I want a little bit more of the blue with the Bling It Blue mixed in it, spreading it. Again the torch, and then I'm almost done, and then we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks after drying. I'm showing it you in the daylight. I hope you can see the sparkle and how nice the gold looks. I'm very pleased how it looks so far. It's very colorful and I like colorful paintings, and also it has some nice sparkle in it. I hope you can see it. I'm trying to show you in different angles so that you also can see the gold that I added. But let me know what you would do. Would you add another layer of resin with some opaque colors, or just leave it as it is? So please let me know in the comment section below this video. I'm very curious. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel, what I already mentioned. Don't forget to click that notification bell. Then you get notified every time I upload a video. Also, if you are interested in my art or in my natural mica pigments, I have added them to my Etsy shop, and also my associate in the USA has added my natural mica pigments in her Etsy shop. The links are in the description box. Also the link to my Facebook and Instagram page and my influencers Amazon store. And I want to thank you all again for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!